Are you coming to the Sunset Picnic Celebration? I hope so. I made this video so that you can understand what's going to happen there and know what to expect. So me and Chris, we had this idea of making this picnic event together with women from all ages and shapes so that we can inspire them, you, and the others that you can bring on working out, on being healthy. But being healthy, not only in the concept of moving your body and eating well, but also into acquiring the sense of knowing that you are supported. And how? Because we are growing a community of love, a community of blissful people that support one another. That's the most important thing of this event. So here's my part. I call it how to have a smiling heart. So that's what we're gonna be doing. I'm going to be doing several activities with you, which is going basically to inspire you to live life in another way, in a different way that you are living. Because life has its ups and downs, and then it has like its plateaus, right? I call it like the seasons of life. So you have like the summer where everybody's celebrating. Then you go like back down to winter where you feel cold and sad and lonely. Then sometimes you are doing your summer thing or your spring and everything is happy. But this that I'm gonna teach you will help you prepare for the winter. Sometimes, you know, if you're not prepared, just like real winter time, then you'll feel cold. But if you're prepared and if you have the proper clothes, then, you know, let's go snow skiing, right? So emotionally, I want to prepare you for when life strikes you with its lows. So recognizing stress so that you can intervene it before it gets too late, before it becomes into depression or you collapse down there and you feel desperate and you don't know what to do. So this is one of the things I'm going to be doing. The other thing is that I will help you understand how to say an effective yes and an effective no. I feel like us women, we are most of the time non-assertive with these two words. Sometimes we say yes, but it really means no. And sometimes we say no, but we say, why did I say yes? So how to get in touch with your yes and no, and how to say it properly, assertively, knowing what you're doing and making your heart smile because you know that you said a yes, that means a yes, right? And I know that it's a no, but it's not aggressive no. You can speak up without being aggressive. And then the other thing I'm gonna teach you is how to know what you really want. And this is a biggie, guys. You know, I like to say that sometimes we have yummy feelings and sometimes we have icky feelings. And between the yummy and the ickies, you get lost. And sometimes you don't really know what you want. Sometimes you identify yourself with the things that are coming in your life that's kind of icky and you think you are that. And sometimes you lose track of the yummies of life. So let's get back to that sensation of having a smiling heart like once we had when we were a kid. So let's bring that child within to come play with us and be a community of women that respect one another, that share things with one another, and mostly have fun. So I can't wait to see you there, and I'll leave you today with a saying from Lao Tzu that I love, that he says, a journey of 1,000 miles, it starts with the first step. The door is open, I hope to see you there. Mwah!